Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial. Today we're looking at adding text boxes for text over images in Photoshop. The first effect we're going to create is using a quote. So I have a quote here from Jack Kerouac. What I've done is to highlight in bold the words that I think are important. So I'm going to enter this as separate objects. So the first one will be there was, and then nowhere, and then to go but. So let's see how we do that. I'm going to select the type tool. I'm going to click where I'm going to start typing. I'm going to use all lowercase, so I'm just going to type there was. And then I'll press escape because that finishes that text object but leaves the type tool intact, so I can just click and add the next piece of type. Now to save us some time, I've already done this. So here are all my type objects. Let's just turn the visibility on all of them. So every second one of these objects is a word that I want to highlight. So I'll just select on them in the layers panel, control click on every second item. Now, if you find that you get a stray empty type box here, just delete it because you don't want any strays in here. It's a little bit too confusing. Now, the font I'm going to use here is called Lemon Tuesday, and I'm going to beef that up to about 500 points on this image. I'm going to leave the rest as just Myriad Pro. I'm not too concerned about the fonts that I'm using here. I'm more concerned about showing you the effects. So now I'm going to select absolutely everything. But before I do that, let's first of all move Jack Kerouac down a little bit. And I also want to size that right down because I don't want that to be big at all. So I'm going to make it 120 points. But then we'll select all of these type objects, and up here we can start arranging them. So I'm going to use this one, which is distribute vertical centers, and that just aligns them so there's a nice space between each of these lines and it's an even spacing. I also want them to align on the right here, so I'm just going to click here on align right, and then I can just move them out of the way so that they're actually in the document a little bit better. Now I need to put a comma in here, so I'm going to add a comma, and doing it at this late stage has meant that this letter E, you'll see that the letter E doesn't actually move, and that's good because the E is going to be lined up with these other letters and the punctuation is going to be slightly out. It can often look better that way. I'm going to add a star at the end of the word star, so I'm going to the brush tool. There are two star brushes here in the Legacy Brushes collection, so click the flyout panel and click Legacy Brushes to add them, but you might want to just add something that is relevant to the kind of quote that you're using. So I've got my star brush selected. I'm going to need a new layer for it because you can't paint on text layer, so let's just click to add a new layer. White paint. Let's see if we can see our star, which I can't, so I'm using the close square bracket just to size it up a little bit. And I'm going to click twice in the same place to get a nice size star. Now the text box I want to use is just going to darken this side of the image, but I don't want it to be really obvious. So let's add a new layer. I'll select the selection tool. I'm going to drag a selection out over all of the text, and I'm going the full length of the image because that's going to help me make this peter out to nothing, and so you won't actually notice that it's there. So I'm going to fill this shape with a gradient, and I want the gradient based on black, so I'm making black my foreground color. When I click gradients, the second gradient in is a foreground to transparent gradient, so we're going from black to transparent. The only thing you need to be aware of is that if you use color to transparent gradients, then when they fill with the color and go across to transparency. If you were using a regular gradient that didn't have any transparency, you could just say, okay, well, I've got this around the wrong way, so I'm just going to drag in the opposite direction. Well, when you've got transparency, that has an additive effect rather than totally replacing it. So I'm going to undo this. And now I'm going to put in the gradient the way I want it to be. So I'm going from black on this side to transparent over here. And when I do that, let's just press Control or Command D to deselect it. You can see that you can't actually see the edge of that gradient. It's all petered out. So all I need to do is to move my gradient filled layer here down to the bottom of the image. And now we can see the text way more clearly. If this is too dark, you can just back off on the opacity. but that transparency on the left-hand side of this shape is helping the box to just blend in with the image. So we're not losing a lot of the image, but we are improving the readability of the type considerably by having this box behind it. So that's the first of our text box effects, a text box that you don't actually see. Let's have a look at something completely different now. For this next text box, I have a different quote, and this quote is, "I put instant coffee in a microwave oven and almost went back in time," and it's by Stephen Wright. In this case, I'm going to take the entire quote, I'm going to make it inside a single box. So I'm going to copy it out of my Word document. Let's go to Photoshop. I'm going to the type tool. I want to work with white, so let's just select white as my color here. And this time I'm going to drag out a box into which my type will be placed. So it's just going to go in as a paragraph. So I'll click in here and press Ctrl or Command V to paste it in. Now I'll go and increase the size of it. So let's just have a look at the sort of size. Think about 300 will work here. Now with this type, I want to highlight some of the words exactly as I did last time, but this time I'm just going to use bold. I'm using Myriad Pro as a font, and that helps me because I've got a lot of different styles in Myriad Pro. So I can use the bold effect, which is built into this font. So I'm just going to set these words to bold. So I like the words instant coffee. I think microwave is important. So I'm going to select bold for this. And then I'm going to select back in time because these are the words that I think are important in this quote. If you want to do an effect like this, it's best to do it with a typeface that comes with lots of different styles so that you can select the style that matches things really nicely. It's better than using, say, a fake bold. So this piece I want to be aligned over to the right, and I want it to be much smaller. So I'm going to set that probably at about 120, and I think I'll just drop that down, so I'll just press the Enter key before I get there. Now I can realign this type here by selecting inside the box here, just clicking inside the box somewhere, and now if I adjust the size of the box, the type flows round. Now if you do that the other way and try and do it with the selection tool, nasty things happen to your type. So just be aware that you need to go and get the type tool. Click in here so that you've got something positioned in here with the type tool, and then you can just size your box to suit. So I want mine to be pretty much like this. I think my font is not quite large enough. Now I'll just move my box into position, and I want it over the top of the cup. It's a little bit difficult to see over the top of the cup, so let's see how we would solve that problem. I'll go to the selection tool and I'll drag out a box. Now I'm going to fill this with a color and place it underneath the type, and it's going to help make the type just a little bit more legible. But before I do that, I want to apply a narrow stroke using this. So what I'll do is create a new layer. I'm going to select a gray color, so let's just go and select a sort of neutral gray. Mine's 165, 165, 165. That just tells me it's gray. Now I'll go to edit and then stroke, and I'm going to put a 3 pixel wide stroke in this color around this shape, and it's going to be on the inside, but doesn't matter much where it is. So I'll just click OK. And so if I move away from here, you can see that's what I've got, this fine line. I'm just going to undo that. So now I'll go to select and modify, and I'm going to contract this. And I want to contract this something like 30 pixels. So I'll just click OK. The selection is now inside that line. So I'm going to add a new layer, and I'm going to fill this with my gray color. So I'll do Alt Backspace Option Delete on the Mac. So now I've got my gray boxes that are going to help my type readability. So I'll grab both of these and move them underneath the type. And I'm going to adjust down their opacity. So I'm going to bring the opacity right down. So they're only just there, but they are going to make the type just a little bit brighter, and they're going to help its readability a bit. I'm not going to do quite as hefty an opacity change on the outer line as I do on the inner one, because I still want to be able to see it. We can link these layers by selecting both of them, right click and choose link layers. And that means if you need to move these boxes, you can do so. So I've got these selected, they're linked, and so they're going to travel together. So if you need to position them slightly differently, they will go as a team because you don't want them to split apart because they're integral to each other. So there is a nice simple text box for placing over the top of an image with some text in it. For the final example, we're going to do a little bit of work with this particular image. I want to crop it first to a square shape. So I've got a one-to-one crop here. So I'm just going to crop it. I'm going to place over the top of it a couple of shapes. I'm using shapes because they're going to help me with the effect I'm trying to get. So I'm going to make sure that I have shapes selected here. I'm going to create a circle first of all. So I'm just going to drag out a circle holding down the shift key as I do and place it sort of roughly in position. Now I want my circle to have a fill but no stroke. So I'm going to the stroke and I'm going to set that to no stroke. I'm now going to add another shape over the top, and that's going to be a square. So I'll select the rectangle, hold the shift key as I drag out a square, and I'm going to place it sort of roughly in position where I want it to be because I want my final shape to be the accumulation of these two shapes. So I don't want this to have a stroke either. It's just going to have a fill. If we have a look in the paths panel, and let's just go and get the layers panel as well, we can see what's going on. So this is my rectangle and this is my ellipse, and I can merge them together into one shape, but before I do that I want to make sure that they're perfectly aligned. So with them selected, I'll go to layer and then align, and I'll choose vertical centers, and then layer, align, horizontal centers, and that makes sure that the two shapes are aligned. I'll right click the selection and choose merge shapes, and that creates a merge shape. Well, it's going to in a minute, but it's not quite merged yet. You can see two distinct shapes here. To merge them, we'll go to this option here and choose merge shape components. And now we're going to get a single shape that is this shape. I want to color it with a color I'm sampling from the image. So I'll go to the eyedropper tool. I'm just going to sample this sort of blue color here. And I want to use that for my rectangle. So I select my rectangle, go back and select some sort of shape tool. So I get these shape options up here, go to fill, and this is the color I want to use. So I've got my blue color, but I also want a sort of border around here. So what I'll do is make a duplicate of this shape. So I've got two of them. The topmost one, I'm going to add a border instead of the fill. So we'll go and select no fill. And for this one, we will select a stroke, and the stroke's going to be the same color as we're using. Now, the stroke is set to 14. That will probably be enough. I'll select the rectangle layer here. I'll go to the move tool, hold the shift key and the alt or option key as I just drag this out, and that allows me to put an edge around my shape. So I'm going to apply this transformation. So I've got these two elements, an offset edge to my shape. I'm going to link these two together as well because I want them to move obviously as a pair. I also want to reduce the opacity of them, and I could also set a blend mode if I wanted to. So you could experiment with different blend modes. Hard light's got some nice color, but that's up to you to see if you can find something that you particularly like. Over the top of this, I'm going to add my text. Now, I don't want this to happen. Photoshop wants to attach this text to something. So let's just go and add a new layer. And now it's prepared to put the text where I want it to be. I'm working in Myriad Pro Regular. I want to work with white. So let's just go and select white. And I'm going to type in season in capitals. Want this to be quite small, so I'll set it at about 120. And then I'll type the word blueberries. I want to be well away from this type when I do that. I'm going to choose an alternate font. I've got one called Alex Brush that I kind of like, and I'm going to increase the font size. Let's try about 400, see how that looks. So I've now got text layered over a text box. We can always improve the legibility of text like this by adding a drop shadow. So let me just select this piece of text. I'm going to the FX icon and I will select drop shadow. And I've got set a really, really small drop shadow. I've got a black or sort of dark blue color here. I've got it set to multiply blend mode. I've got sort of middling opacity, but the distance here is set to 1, the spread is set to 2, and the size is 0. So this is only just a drop shadow, but it's enough to improve the readability of the type. If you turn it on and off, you'll see a very slight difference, and it's just lifting that type a little bit away from the image, and it's just improving its readability just a little bit. Now, you could increase this to say 2 pixels. It's going to depend on the image and the typeface that you're using, but I find that that really helps with the text over the image. I hope that you've enjoyed learning these Photoshop techniques. Let us know what you think in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.